Pratt & Whitney partnered with the University of Connecticut to create one of the most advanced additive manufacturing laboratories in the nation.
Additive manufacturing has been around since 1970s. Over the past decade, it has gone through tremendous growth and it has a huge potential for revolutionizing the way we make objects.
In a conventional manufacturing process, one would take a block of metal and machine away the material to get to the final part shape. So you're subtracting material with a lot of waste to make one part. Additive manufacturing is a joining of materials, usually layer by layer. It is a green technology because it reduces the amount of raw material required. The additive manufacturing technologies at the University of Connecticut are focused on the powder bed technologies, both electron beam and laser powder bed technologies.
Some of the earlier additive manufacturing processes were strictly plastics, and the parts that came out of those processes were great for ergonomic design, fit design, but weren't very strong. The EBM process, probably the highest tech, highest advanced technology process, takes fine grains of Inconel or titanium, sand if you will, and takes a layer of that sand, and then an electron beam from above comes down, follows a pattern of the part, and the process goes on and on layer by layer, until when you're done you take out a fully developed part.
The object that is created in additive manufacturing is very strong and therefore could be used in applications of high demand like in jet engines, in biomedical implants, in dental implants, or many other applications.
Pratt & Whitney chose the University of Connecticut as the location for the Additive Manufacturing Innovation Center because UConn has excellent technical capabilities that complement our fundamental research needs.
Availability of this center on campus would create an opportunity for the students, for the faculty, as well as for actually many smaller and larger industry in the state of Connecticut to have access to hands-on training, to use them on demand for their research activities, for project activities, and actually to learn hands-on how to use these machines.
This is what's going on in the industry, and it's important that we have it here so that the engineers going out in the field are familiar with it and understand that this is going to be a part of engineering and industry and manufacturing for years and years to come. This is the future.